Welcome back to the channel, 361 fam. We're back again. Part two of my cam install. If you haven't seen in the previous video, yes, we did get the old moist ram. Oh, sorry about all the fog on the lens. The humidity is stupid today. It's stupid high. But I got y'all. We'll just use this nice soft cloth here. There we go. So anyway, we got the ram all tore apart. We got the DMS cam, performance cam, stuffed in there. That's the Hellraiser cam. Also got the valve springs put on the heads. So the heads got the new valve springs and stuff in them. One thing I wanted to show y'all is the actual... Dang it, guys. This damn fog, man. I'm gonna have to hold this rag, I guess. I don't know. It's like it doesn't want to stop. One thing I wanted to show y'all is the original cam. If you look down the lobes on the cam, you can kind of see where she was getting a little worn. That's 70,000 miles with the MDS turned off after 20,000 miles. You can see all the points where it's starting to get shiny. That's where it's starting to try to eat the cam. Now, it's kind of normal to see some shininess, but that's a little excessive. One of the peaks on these lobes is actually showing, hang on, let me find her. But yeah, the lobe right there, you can see that one's starting to show a sign of failure. So I haven't checked the actual lifter bearings yet. So I don't know, guys, there's obviously an issue with the factory setup one way or another. I ran AMSOIL on this thing religiously and AMSOIL did great. I also seen some signs of a little bit of side wear on these lifters. You can kind of see where it goes from being nice and dull to polished on one side. It's got a little bit of side wear to it. I haven't really messed with the rollers too much to see if there's any slack in those. My main goal right now is to get this bad boy put back together because I know that everything I have is ready to go in. So by the end of this video, you will be getting the startup on the cammed ram, the cammed moist ram, the slam cam moist ram. It's gonna have the bam bam in it too, but we'll hold out for that. We'll hold out for that video. Anyway, guys, without further ado, I'm gonna get my breakfast taco, I'm gonna get my breakfast drink, and we'll get y'all in the time lapse. We'll get this bad boy going. If you haven't already, make sure to hit the like button, make sure to subscribe, make sure to share the content, and check out the merch store, link down below. Anyway. Oh, yeah. Guys, so I know it's dark and I know it's late. We did not get this guy finished up. I'm lacking the front cover, I'm lacking injectors, I'm lacking a few other things, but hopefully here within the next hour or so, I'm gonna go ahead and stay late and I'm gonna go ahead and finish this guy. So I did have problems with the manifold studs. They were broken, so I had to drill out some manifold studs. It took it out of me, guys. I'm sorry, I'm so dead. But I've been working since 9 o'clock and I think it's also already 9, so I put about 12 hours into it today. Altogether have about 24 hours into this guy. So anyway, with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and let y'all go with that. If I forget to film an outro, I'm sorry, but you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and do it now, and if we get her started up, I'll throw the first start in the video. I kill myself for these videos, guys. So hit the like button, make sure to subscribe. We'll catch you next time. All right, so moment of truth. We're uploading the cam file, Demon Motorsports cam file, to the truck right now. It is currently 12:30 at night, and you know, I went through and crossed my T's and dot my I's, and it took me a little bit longer than expected, but okay, so it's done writing. So here comes the moment of truth. Like, yeah. Oh, we don't have any leaks, right? Like, I'm gonna turn the ignition on again, but I don't think I have like any fuel leaks or anything. Everything seems to be good. Yeah, okay. Very scary. Did it die?
Yeah.
Just pull another one off. So far, it's sounding normal. I mean, sounds like it's actually missing, but it's got a cam in it now. But I don't hear any ticking or anything. All right, here we go for oil circulation number two.
Nothing out of the driver's side. Oh my God, nothing on the passenger side.
All right, let's pull the dipstick real quick and just check the oil level, make sure everything's copacetic with that. So nervous, like, you don't even know.
Just think, man, it's a 50-50 shot.
How's she looking as far as... Flip it over? Yeah, we need to add.
All right, here we go. Topping off the old moist greasy.
Sorry, I'm holding a oil bottle and a GoPro at the same time. By the way, shout out to Amsoil for keeping this motor healthy as long as it's been healthy. It's funny how it fits perfectly. Like, you can screw it right into it. I'm just kidding. That's good enough for me. This is third time's the charm, right? Here we go. Whew. Whew. It's currently 12:38 in the morning. Here we go for the initial first start. Everything looking good?
Everything's looking good.
All right, we're gonna go again.
like a choppy boy on a soft tune. She's a little warm now. Holy shit.
A little smoky.
Well, yeah, yeah. There's all kinds of shit all over the headers and stuff. As long as we're not like jizzing oil out.
Yeah, I didn't see anywhere.
I told you I'd start it before the end of the video, so stay tuned. Tomorrow we're putting it together, we're putting water in it, antifreeze, all that good stuff. We're gonna get it buttoned up and hopefully take it for a first drive. I don't know, we'll see what happens when I put water in it. It ain't got no water in it, so if the, you know, if something's crazy on the water side, I could get water in the oil and we could be back to square one. So anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed the video. We'll catch you next time. Rep 361 Texas, we're out.